Good afternoon. Wow, that's loud. Good afternoon and welcome to the Meadows School of the Arts and to Southern Methodist University. I did some quick math, and math isn't my strong suit. In fact, I'm still looking for that strong suit. But this is my 204th concert here, and probably 202 of them have been in the evening. So I was pretty happy to say, remember to say good afternoon. Rather than good evening. We are profoundly grateful that you chose to join us for today's performance. It's a Jewish holy day, and it's a Christian holy day. It's a sunny afternoon, and the fact that you all came, and all of you watching at home from your favorite chair, I hope, we're grateful that you joined us. We have a lot of clappers in the house, and it's always good to have clappers. These green seats are rather silent. So it's good to have clappers, and all of you at home, you're going to have to clap really, really loudly. I understand we have a couple hundred people online, so we've got a full house, just some of them are making their own house full. Today's program is a one-hour matinee with no intermission, and there are two very special pieces on the program, two pieces of historical significance. The first piece is Richard Strauss, the Vienna Philharmonic Fanfare, was written in 1924. Actually, it was written in 23, performed in 24 at the first Vienna Philharmonic Ball, and has been performed at every ball since that time. And it's a brass player's staple. I was a trombone player in a former life, and believe me, we love playing the Strauss. And I think you'll enjoy it. It's conducted by a good friend and a dear colleague from the University of Texas at Arlington, Douglas Stoddard. The second piece on the program, we have some pretty good program notes, but I just want to tell you, this is a piece that changed music history, especially for people who play instruments that need air to play, wind and brass instruments. But there's some mysteries of when the piece was written. Most people date it around 1781. To 1784. But up until that time, wind performance was largely diverting music. It was dinner music. It was what in the old days, I guess I'm old enough to remember a few of us in here, muzak, elevator music, right? It was parlor music. Well, kind of like Beethoven with his third symphony, the Eroica, Mozart with this piece changed music history, both with regard to the length of the piece and the seriousness of the piece. And in one piece, he elevated one performance to an artistic level. The piece is a monster. It's rarely heard in its entirety live. A lot of people play it, but they leave out all the repeats. And if and those musicians in the room that have studied classical form, if you leave out the repeats, you're no longer playing a classical piece. You've messed with the form of the piece. So it's a one-hour matinee, about a 3.5-4-minute fanfare that my colleague and friend Doug Stoddard will conduct. And then you're in for a treat. You'll get to hear Mozart's Serenade No. 10 in B-flat major, also called the Gran Partita, though he never called it that. In the manuscript score, it's not his hand that has penciled in Gran Partita on the top, but it's certainly a grand piece, and I think you'll enjoy it. You'll notice that piece, some people wonder why sometimes I use a stool. It's not because I'm lazy. They can basically play it without me. So the times where they need me, I'll stand up and I'll kind of nod, and the rest of the time, I'll even have a better seat than all of you do to hear the piece. I hope that you all picked up your autographed can of Vienna sausages. Mozart stopped by earlier in the week and autographed close to 400 cans. So feel free to take more than one. They're out there on the table. Now, they're good souvenirs. But before you eat it, you might want to read the first ingredient. Mechanically separated chicken. Don't ask me what it is. I don't know when the Gran Partita was written, so I don't know. But I got a feeling it's not a good thing. Anyway, but it's so funny, our former orchestra conductor who retired, he said, you know, I only moved one thing from my office to Boston when I retired. He goes, it's that Mozart autographed can of Vienna sausages, which my grandmother, she had been out of state, she'd never been out of the country, She referred to them as Vienna sausages. And this was grade A cuisine at grandma's house. So there's your souvenir. There are also some posters. There are some extra posters out there. We're delighted that you joined us. It means a lot that you're here. Enjoy the program, and it should go roughly an hour, start to finish. Thank you so much.
Thank you.